you know, got skanks. Everybody, you know what I'm saying?
Well, it's the M.I. Cricket letter, ain't no one better. And when I'm on the microphone, you best to wear your sweater, cause I'm cooler than the polar bear's toenails. Oh, hell, there he go again, talking that bend corners like I was a curve. I struck a nerve, and now you're about to see the Southern player serve. I heard it's not where you from, but where you pay rent. Then I heard it's not what you make, but how much you spend. You got me bent like elbows, amongst other things, but I'm not worried. Cause when we set up in the party, like I'm out, you serving. So go get your time box and your sack of nickels. It like tickles to see you try to be like Mr. Pickle.
You know, the same mother. I want them to know that I'm fucking with them. Alright, I can't afford my Outkast, sue me. But, yeah. It should be so abrupt when I cut that shit off. Anywho, how y'all doing? What's going on, everybody? On this good here Saturday, how you doing? What you doing? How's it going? So on and so forth. Oh shit, I'm playing the video in the background. Sorry for being a little bit late. I had very important business to do. I had to poop. So, that's why I'm late. Well, I'm like 2 minutes late. It's not really a big deal. Oh shit, I'm saying I'm late. I might not even know I was fucking late. I'm lying. No big deal. Nobody was late. It's a mistake. But, yeah. Happy to be in here yet again on this here good Saturday. I'm trying not to jump into the fucking alien thing. Like, I want to set that up, like, and make it make sense and make it sound like I'm like this cohesive, good quality show. But I'm really just, nobody's talking about that. Not like it's brand new shit, but like just nobody's bringing that shit up. And I don't understand, because I feel like that's the way more fun topic than, you know, our fucking, I'm tired of Corona. Corona's fucking boring now. You know, wash your hands, don't die, stay in the house. Let's get some crazy shit going. Let's talk about the weird shit. Or I guess we'll get to the weird shit. It's not like it's going anywhere. But yeah, I made a post about that shit like the other day, and I just was like, yeah, man, like nobody's fucking having conversations about the weirdo shit. But you know, whenever you hear this, you know, ask yourself, you know. Ask yourself about the aliens, about the weirdo shit. I'm waiting for DC to get here, because I feel like that's probably when we're gonna like just abuse this topic to no fucking end. For right now, it's just me talking about nonsense. About let's stretch it out. Let's dial it back. How was you guys' week? Are you guys hearing me? If you guys are out there, if you want to call in, say anything. My week was good. My week was chill. I had a little less fuck it this week. I felt productive. I did some work. Had wasn't like anything intense I did, but I was just made an attempt to be way more productive, way more focused with my shit. So I'm proud of me. I'm gonna give myself a round of applause for being an upstanding adult and mildly. Shit, that's long. I feel like I didn't deserve that many applause. It was like at the first like 2.5 seconds it could have stopped. But yeah, I was mildly productive this week. Trying to be good out here, you know, trying to act like I'm appreciative of my essential work shit. I have seen, because I think it was out here too. What was that? Huntington? People are still kind of wilding out about that shit. I definitely saw in like those other states where motherfuckers was just like, yeah, you know, we'll be out here dressed as the fucking forefathers militia with guns. And I know it's always like it always will fall back to, you know, what's that dude? What's the white privilege? And you know, and it's true, it's a thing. But I just be like, man, don't nobody ever, like, I want to know, like, are there other white people that just look at it, not even from, like, you know, white people get more privileged than black people, but just, do you guys ever look at that shit and just go, this is a really crazy fucking way to respond to shit? Like, I want to go to work. I want to go, you know, and kind of dial it back on this in-the-house shit, and I'm losing money, and, you know, my business, my whatever your issue is with being inside, if you just fucking tired of looking at yourself. But I need to understand, like, you know what sounds like a good idea? To go to the costume store and get a George Washington outfit on top of my fatigues, and then to go, yeah, I got like a fucking semi-automatic weapon, and I'm gonna walk outside and I'm just gonna fucking stand with my gun, and that's gonna fucking that's gonna get the fucking job done. That's what's gonna do it. I'm gonna show them. I'm gonna walk up and I'm gonna, my rats. I assume, like, you know, everything has its course, but I don't know how many times motherfuckers could do the same shit and think that shit's cool. I don't know why people just, like, the first, maybe not, okay, what is it, not all? Do I have to preface white people with not all? Is that, like, the nice thing to do, or, I don't know, it seems like universally people don't care, you know, if you're gonna get your I'm mad rocks off, you get it off of white folks, so maybe I didn't have to say, like, you know, not all, but whatever, like, yeah, yo, them motherfuckers just, I don't know, like, I just, they confuse me. I'm not even from a space of, like, you know, if that would have been us, we would have got shot, and we would have got fucking annihilated if that was us to do the other way around, or they would have approached it, not to say we would get annihilated, I got faith in us, but they would have approached it with, like, oh, this is the end of the fucking world. But yeah, them niggas just seem like, I don't know, their whole energy is just always fucking insanity to me, and I don't understand it. I don't know if there's any, does anybody know or have any crazy ass redneck white person that they, you know, like, my rights are being fucking infringed because whatever, like, have them contact me. I would just like to know. I want to have that conversation. It just confuses me, you know, and I don't even think I'm here to, like, make jokes or make fun just yet, but I am just ridiculously confused at how that works, and this shit's fucking funny, I'm not gonna lie. Like, I know it shouldn't be as entertaining as it is, but it's funny to me from time to time. But oh no, I can't do that, my bad. I was gonna go live, but I realized I have, like, things that I eventually want to talk about, so y'all almost, oh, you didn't see it on the fucking, that people that are listening, but the people who, like, when I put this video up, yeah, I fucking put this live up like I was gonna fucking do some super shit. But yeah, I don't know. That's the only news I've kept up with, because I try not to. I've never been somebody who's, like, just super super, like, into the news. But I keep up to with that shit via, like, what is it? What's that fucking page? There's a page, like, I follow a lot of, like, the news pages on Instagram. Now this is pretty good. Like, they give me enough news and enough little spurts where I feel like I've got, like, a good gist of things, because I see, like, my aunt, and, like, I hear, like, about my grandma and stuff like that, and they be, like, watching the news, and I'm like, fuck, bro, that's, like, a, I don't know, that's, like, a, like, I don't want to be uninformed, but that shit is also, like, a wild recipe for, like, just depression and anxiety, and, oh, shit, like, the fucking world's gonna implode every fucking day. Like, still, like, talking about, Corona and whatnot, like, not to say that Corona is something to avoid or not pay attention to, but I walked in the house the other day, and, like, the news was on, and it was just like, today, coronavirus. I was like, fuck, nigga, like, you can't, what about the weather, you know? We don't want to talk about this nice Friday weather, nothing. We don't want to do that. You just straight into fucking, the world is fucking ending, and news at 2. What's happening? News at 2. Hey, man, look, it's sunny outside, but also you can't even go out there and enjoy it. Why? Because you can't fucking breathe. Because fucking Corona. I don't know. Shit's, what was I talking about? Corona? No, I was talking about, like, news consumption. My bad. But, yeah, I just feel like, I don't know, something about getting it in spurts and just giving me the hot little bullet points so I can go on about my day knowing it is cool. I think sometimes, like, the news, like, what's that shit? What's the word for it? A bit of fear mongering, because it just, like, they're just living in, oh shit, are you scared? Are you scared as fuck yet? No, well, let us fucking destroy your shit completely, you fear filled fuckers. I like it, but yeah, I don't know. I think that I don't know. I think that's just like a. I think it's dangerous. I guess because I'm not in the mindset of not taking shit seriously. Like I feel like we've discussed that before, but definitely is not good to like live in that space. Holy shit! So I went to Yahoo to see if there's any like you know recent news things or just any bullshit that I have passed up and like once again. The world is like weird because coronavirus is number two to Kourtney Kardashian. I don't want to click it because I don't want to like. But like, how the fuck does. Damn, yo, the Kardashian shit. Like, are y'all. Somebody please like just explain to me like what is it? Like, I'm not trying to diss. I'm not trying to even shit. I don't understand how Kourtney Kardashian is trending higher than a pandemic. I don't even know where the fuck I was headed with that. Where I was, holy shit, that's crazy. I mean, it's Yahoo, so I don't really know what numbers like Yahoo or how to divvy up the information that Yahoo's producing, like the real top tier news. But holy shit, my nigga, that is fucking insanity. That really blew me. That's wild. that's a sick, powerful family, yo. Like. I don't even know if that would be, like, fun to have that many people just, you know, please listen to my show and, like, everything that I say. But at the same time, like, that's a lot of fucking just unnecessary power that, you know, like, oh, shit, Kourtney Kardashian fucking stubbed a toe today, nigga. Crazy as fuck. We got to talk about it. We have to know things. We have to be in it. That's fucking crazy. I don't like it. That's, what the fuck? Yeesh. Sorry, I'm completely like off whatever half-ass bullshit topic I thought I was gonna have, but that blew me the fuck away. Anywho, moving on. I just saw something that kind of brought me back. I saw they have here the politics thing for like Joe Biden, and that's a scary fucking thing. I saw earlier this week. I would like to assume, like, you know, mad people saw it, but like Diddy was like, I'm finna Diddy bop all over the vote, man. Y'all, we rocking the vote, and y'all can't. We not doing the same thing no more. We not. Which I agree. I think people took, which is what people do. It seems like take what somebody says in the only perspective they know how. So I know, like, I probably should have pulled up a clip, but I'm lazy right now. But basically, it seemed like Diddy was saying, like, you know, not to vote. People took it as, oh, vote for Trump and you're endorsing Republicans and blah, 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 which I don't think that's what he was saying. Like, from what I heard, from what I took from Diddy's statement is that, you know, black people seem like they're really conditioned to go with the Democrats or that side of what's that shit called? Like. Left, right, on the left, and for no reason other than just like blind allegiance. And I don't think that he was flat out saying like join Trump and them. He was just saying hold Democrats accountable. And looking at like, you know, and then it's not like Joe Biden is like the most amazing fucking I think he gets a lot of you know, we give him a lot of room because, oh shit, that's Obama's homeboy, like he was riding with Obama and like he's like the super you know, cool white dude that like, but you know, like, if you know, there's been plenty of research into his participation in like crime bills and stuff like that. So, and even when they were talking about, I would say that how people look at that relationship more of like he's cool because he was with Obama, as opposed to that being like Obama pulling a strategic like political move of going, like, I know like Biden is sometimes has been described as kind of like, what is it, like the Republicans Democrat, or I heard something like that, like he's just like he knows how to play the game, he's a really good politician. So if I'm a black president, I know I got a lot of obstacles going against me, I'm going to pick the dude in my party, but the dude in my party my enemies fuck with. You know what I mean? Like, it was, you know, and it's not to undermine anything Obama did or any shit like that, but it just was, I feel like it was more, I think people sometimes don't look at it from that point. Like, it wasn't like Biden was like this really cool, super progressive, I love black people and everything great, you know, type shit. It was like Obama's like, all right, I'm trying to get my ass in office. I need to get a motherfucker who can make sure these motherfuckers maybe not be on my side, but they don't get in my way like they could. And I think that is just a viewpoint that people overlook. And when you look at, like, you know, there's plenty of issues and obstacles that black people face, you know, in this country, and you vote for a motherfucker so they can go, hey, you voted for me, I get, like, now it's my turn to pay you back for what you voted for me so I could fix A, B, and C. Now, on our end, I would say niggas got to really put together, like, an A, B, and C, and it's just, like, that's what I felt like what Diddy was saying. It's like, I'm not fucking with y'all no more, because every time we put y'all there, y'all don't really give a shit. Them motherfuckers over there, though, like, when they put they boy in there, that nigga swings dick, who doesn't give a shit, who likes it or doesn't like it, makes shit happen for the people that put him in there. But that's because those people also, you know, they band together and hold him accountable. It's like, oh, if you don't, you know, you don't do this, nigga, we will, you know, we'll pull support, we'll get you the fuck up out of here. So I just, you know, I feel like that's one thing that I would say that we could, yeah, we could learn from that other side. Like, the other side really ride with they shit. Like, okay, I think maybe the crazy motherfuckers in, like, you know, bumfuck Alabama or some shit, like, they might just do, you know, flat out, I vote for him because, you know, he's white and he looks like, you know, my cousin Abner, and I fucking like him. I like him. I like how he speaks. I like how he talks. What about his policy? I don't give a fuck about the policy. He said guns. So there are those. But then they're like, you know, the quote-unquote educated voters, like, you know, I've invested, so I know that this motherfucker can help me capitalize on my investment. So, hey, I don't disagree with Diddy in that regard. Like, I think that that's what he meant. I think it's, like, not necessarily just pull your shit away from, you know, Democrats altogether. It's like, nah, man, you pull your shit away, and then you hold them accountable. You just have a set, you know, a set thing for how you want. I have desires. We have desires as a people. We want this, this, and this. So in order for you to do this, like, just an even, simple exchange of goods and services, my nigga, your job is to push these things through in order for us to have, you know, a better, whatever, way of life, way of this, way of whatever. So, yeah, there was a couple things I saw where people, like, being a little nitpicky for Diddy for saying, like, we're going to do a thing for black businesses, and it turned into minority shits. So I know that usually turns into a conversation of, like, why can't we ever just ride for ourselves? Which I get. I don't know if that's what, you know, I can't speak for Diddy, but it is, you know, it does always seem a little bit like, you know, it starts out as, we're doing stuff for black folks. And then everybody else get mad, like, why is it just black people? Why can't it just be everybody else? And then it turns into all, you know, minorities. So that weird gray area, I feel like, you know, I don't necessarily say you criticize it before, but if you want to have it, like, that could be talked about. I think that other shit is people just putting their views on it, because I think the nigga said some shit that, you know, should be said, like, you're not fucking with us, and y'all just always claim this real, we are, you know, for the people shit, but this group of people that look like me, we get left out. Another thing I'm creeped out about with the Biden shit, just rolling with this whole whatever, is there's all this shit that's coming out with bro being like a wild, creepy, like, sex. It looks like the fucking election is going to be like Battle of the Sex Offenders. Like, Trump just an aggressive grab him by the pussy. Yeah, man, you know, sometimes I might have just been like, yeah, suck a dick, because I'm fucking Trump. Like, his just seems like aggressive, douchey, I want you to touch my. And then everything you see with Biden, like, every time, like, he's like hugged up with a girl or hugged up with somebody, it just, it seemed like they creep, like, it's just like, yo, please stop. It seems like when you watch one of those, like, fucking, you know, Lifetime movies, and you can tell there's, like, some weird dynamic between this creepy teacher and, like, his fucking student, and she's wild, uncomfortable. It seems like that shit. Like, Biden gives off that type of energy, which is, which also becomes, like, a weird conversation of, like, okay, do you vote for somebody knowing that, because everybody had, all these niggas are, like, you know, if you probably opened and looked in their real lives, they terrible. So it's like, if the motherfucker, like, promises and can actually enact the things that can benefit the country, do you just, like, overlook that, hey, like, bro's a bit of a fucking, you know, he might do, like, you know, he's got little spirit fingers, you know, a little, little motherfucker, a little weirdo, you know? Because if, you know, if we overlooking Biden because he's, like, a presidential candidate, well, then, you know, Bill up here, you know, fucking just locked down because he, like, no-dose pussy. And, yeah, that's, I don't know, that's a weird, that's a weird-ass lane and a weird-ass fucking shit to be having to, hasn't, wait, that's been, like, a big, I mean, I not to say that it's never been a shit, but never been, like, a thing, but it just seems like that just has been blowing up lately, like, you had the fucking, you know, you got R. Kelly, you got, and I don't know that that's R. Kelly, you got Bill Cosby, then this fucking Epstein shit that just poofed, went away, kind of, or hung away, and then, you know, Biden and all these, like, little weird conspiracies and shit. I don't know, it's like, just this weird sex offender thing is, it's uncomfortable, like, I don't know exactly what to do with that information, because then it turns into, you know, one of these, like, conspiracy topics of, like, oh, you know, if you, Epstein didn't kill himself, and there's all these, like, weird fucking theories and shit, and I don't have enough information on any of that shit to become, like, the fucking theory guy that, what's that shit, like, that meme where it's, the dude from, Always Sunny in Philadelphia, and he's got, like, the fucking red shits tapped to this one and that one. Yeah, that shit, I don't want to be that guy, but, yeah, it's just, I don't know, it's mad, weird, confusing, and disgusting shits, and fuck a corona, like, that shit to me is, like, makes life mad uncomfortable, because I gotta sit here and, like, I know other countries have to, like, they gotta look at us and just go. And this might be me having, like, American arrogance, because I have no fucking idea what's going on in, like, Canada. Oh, wait, take that back. I know one thing that's going on in Canada. Maybe I'll talk about that. But, like, I don't know anything about prime minister, you know, fucking, I don't know, milk tits from whatever country. But everybody seems to always know us, and it's just always, like, you niggas are fucking, like, just look dumb. Like, we got two potential sex offenders just up here. Even though, you know, any movie makes it seem like all fucking politicians sex, you know, so maybe we're not that different. Maybe everybody else is just, maybe we just are too American and arrogant to give a fuck about other countries that we don't know that all these motherfuckers are just trash. So I take that back. My bad. Everybody's trash. Everybody's equally trash. Just trash ass people in trash ass positions of trash ass power. It's a lot of trash ass shit. But, oh, that's what I saw from the Canada thing. Once again, from, like, that fucking, I swear, like, I don't know, like, the little quick snippets of information, just boom, boom, boom. And then if you want to go fucking, you know, read a big-ass article, you could. But I like the little, you know, fuck all the exposition, extra words. Hit me with the goddamn Snapple facts. But it was, I forget what happened in Canada. I have a whole computer and two screens, but then I have to sit here and be quiet while you guys watch me, like, fucking look it up. So I'm not going to do that. But the basically was, I think it was, like, the dude in Canada. I'm, like, 80% sure it was Canada, because it looked like the dude. Was it that same dude who's in that picture with, like, Trump? It looked like he was going to take his bitch. But they did this thing where it was, like, I guess they're banning all the guns. Or at least I think it was, I don't know if it's all the guns, but it definitely was, like, you know, the assault rifles and the fucking, like, you know, all the shits the motherfuckers had when they was protesting that they want to come outside because they can't go outside. Like, the motherfuckers outside in, like, you know, you know, them fucking forefather outfits and 17, you know, banana clip shits. Like, they were banning those. And I don't know. Like, there's a part of me that's like, yeah, you as a regular fucking person, you know, you don't, there's really no need to have those walking outside. But I don't know that I'm 100% for just being able to take guns, because, you know, which is why also, like, these blind allegiances to, like, either side, because you could find like, you know, some shit you agree with on the other side. But everybody has this whole idea that, like, if you are, you know, left or right, that you got 100% ride with that shit, even though neither one of them motherfuckers got, like, 100%, I don't know, vote the issue. Which is another thing I think Diddy was talking about. But anyways, like, I can't say, I got a couple, like, you know, homies, military people, and they always, like, dick hard for guns. But the logic behind it, which is, like, you know, everybody says they don't trust, like, I don't trust the government. Like, they could be, you know, doing terrible, dirty shit to fuck with us. And the idea that, you know, if this motherfucker ever, you know, exploded, that you would be like, okay, I need my guns to, like, protect myself. So I would say I don't understand why there's not, like, a way to split the middle. Like, no, I don't think you should be able to have, like, a fucking rocket launcher at your house, but you should be able to, like, have guns. But there just might not ever really be, like, you shouldn't be just walking down the street with, like, a semi-automatic weapon. So I don't know if the thing with Canada was just like, you can keep handguns, or we're gonna take those other shits, or something like that. I feel like it would have been, like, an easy fix to, like, put, like, more legislation on it. Like, you should, I don't know, I feel like it's easier to get a goddamn gun than it is to go, I feel like, you know, you shouldn't be able to get a gun at the same ease you can go get a fucking, you know, pair of shoes. Like, I feel like even that probably would, like, deter shit, but I'm not a goddamn politician or fucking lawmaker, but I feel like I'm a logical, you know, human being. And if you are a motherfucker who's like, yeah, I want guns, we need guns, there's a logic where, yeah, that makes sense, because these motherfuckers in power are not always, like, you know, they're not great people. Like, and I think sometimes, definitely here in the Americas, you know, you watch, I know I've said something like this before, but, like, you watch some of these movies or you watch some of the shit on the news, and all this, like, post-apocalyptic shit, you know, shit blowing up in the street, motherfuckers, like, you know, kicking down doors. Like, you think that can't be you, because you think, like, you know, America's some super refined fucking country when we was out there fucking beating niggas' asses for toilet paper. So, I don't know, like, I get it. I just would say that maybe, you know, I don't fucking know, man. Like, maybe don't do that. You know, maybe just, It takes nothing. I don't know. It seems like, I mean, it's clearly other shit. It's obviously, like, plays for power and shit that's not necessarily on the quote unquote up and up. But yeah, that shit don't make no fucking sense to me. You know, like, you could split, I guess, what is that? Split the middle. So yeah, I don't know. The gun shit is a weird thing. Like, I find myself now as I get older kind of going, like, I used to be like, I remember, like, being in college, like, there's no need for guns, and that's terrible. But now I'm like, oh no, nah, motherfucker, like, you know, shit, if anybody need guns, it's definitely, you know, black people. Like, just, you know, I like, you know, keep my fire on me a little bit, man. You know, it ain't nothing, but, you know, I trust us to be more of in a realm of, like, you know, I just need you to back the fuck up off me. I don't really feel like going to fucking fuck with y'all. Like, I just want y'all to, you should always just have the ability to keep a motherfucker up off you. And if that motherfucker is quote unquote the government, then, you know, you should have that, because, you know, on the other end, you know, but then, you know, you have motherfuckers in Orange County with guns, like, and shit, like, protesting about going outside, and people using oh, I saw that shit the other day. It was the mindset, the fact of, okay, because I feel like it ties into the Orange County people, which sounds like the people who, like, are at any of these places protesting. Those are the same people that believe that shit like that Karen is a fucking racial slur. And that's terrifying. It's terrifying that somebody would that could fix their motherfucking mouth to say to say that we're all Karens is a racial slur. I got to figure out where that phrase came from. I don't know how Karen, I don't know how to rank them, because a Karen just sounds like the annoying white woman, you have the Karen in the Apple store with the fucking bob cut, Apple Care was supposed to take care of this, and she brings in her whole goddamn desktop and slams it on the fucking table, and they're like, ma'am, your shit is, it was expired 6 months ago. How the fuck is that? Like, she's making a scene. But then you got Becky's, and, Becky's are out here sucking dick, amazingly so. They got a song and everything. So how do you determine, a Becky and an Ashley? Can you go from a Becky? It seems like you can go from a Becky to an Ashley. I mean, not a Becky. A Becky to a fucking, who's an Ashley? Is Ashley Ashley? I know enough Ashleys that aren't white, so you can't use it. But can you go from a Becky to a Karen? It seems like you can go. It used to be a Becky. You grew into being some piece of shit. Life hit you fast. Your father told you, you'll be disowned, and then you grew into a Karen. But I think if we can get Karens to transition back to Becky's, it'd be a little more peace in the world. So if you're out there being a Karen, if you know a Karen, then I think we should probably, try to put together some type of think tank from Karens back to Becky's. Becky's were okay. Becky's came, sucked a little dick, came here to party, get fucked up, do that stupid ass hair flip shit dance they be doing where it just seemed like, they spines get a little jelly with it, and it's all this shit that they do, and it's like that dance. Like, if you ever watched the Fantastic Four 2 second movie, they got the Silver Surfer in there, and when you're watching the Silver Surfer, his powers, they come up from the board, up his legs, up his body, and then he shoots them at you. And that seems like how white women do that dance in the club. It builds at their ankles, and then they just feel everything up here, and then they always put their hands through their hair, and that apparently is the shit. I need to talk to more white boys, because I need to know if that does some shit. I want to know if that's are they building up sex power, because white people be shit like Wiccans and shit. So it'd be Wiccan sex magic up through the fucking spine and poof. And now I got your fucking balls in a vice grip, Connor. And we're going to go out here and, fuck on a boat or whatever. They be doing that shit. I watch the movies. They be fucking on boats. My dad's boat is out here. And Becky's out here. Now I'm thinking, because I don't know if those are Becky's, because Plies act like Becky's was just fucking us. Give me that Becky. So is Becky's just the ones that are fuck you, dad. And their dads are a redneck politician, but they fuck it, I'm gonna go out here and get some black dick. So are those Becky's, or are Becky's just with the shits with all races? Fuck, man, I need to, this might have to be a series. I need to do a follow-up, because I'm trying to understand. I'm trying to have more of a dialogue and understanding culturally. I'm trying to have cross-cultural discourse. And I need to understand if Becky's are for everyone, or if Becky's are race-specific. Do the names change per race, Because are Becky's for the Latin community, or Becky's for the Asian community? This is I'm very intrigued. I've done a thing. I don't know if you all could tell, but I'm proud of me, because this theory, I know a few white women, and I know it's a lot of you niggas out there that are white women connoisseurs. So I feel like we can get to the bottom of this and get to the bottom of this by next week. To understand if Becky's are sincerely just for black people, or if Becky's are for the group. And if so, if Becky's are just for black people, then do the names change? And then at what point do you transition into a Karen? And if you become a Karen, is a Karen permanent? Can you reverse your Karen-ness? Because nobody seems to like a Karen. It seems like white people don't like Karens. What about the women who are actually named Karen that might be cool? I don't know any cool Karens. If anybody knows a cool Karen, I'm sorry for her. So, I don't know. This has all just become so... We've come down a rabbit hole here, but I'm going to continue to hit the gas on it. Because these are the real deep questions and thoughts we need to have that we need to bring to the aliens. Thought I was not going to talk about that. They're here. Like, I saw... I keep fucking falling back to that little... I know I said their name on here, but I keep going back to the little news shit that I see on Instagram. Because I follow them. I follow them all the time, and they always give me fucking news. So I have no choice but to, like, just... I'm not going to say their name, though, because I want them to pay me money one day so I can just have terrible fucking commentary on their good-ass site. But anyways, they was up there talking about... There was, like, a video. There was a fucking a video or whatever. And it was this fucking... what's his name? It was this fucking... why am I on this one? It was this fucking... pilot. It was just like Air Force pilot. He was fucking he's flying or whatever. He sees a I guess what they're calling, instead of a UFO and then what's an unidentified flying object, they're calling it a goddamn UAP, unidentified aerial phenomena, which is fucking beyond me. But, yeah, so bro is up there and he's, and you know, they have footage now and I just, and it's like, you know, it flew. He was like, it was the fastest thing I've ever seen. It was, you know, some, I don't know. It was crazy. Apparently it was just defying the fucking laws of physics. So I just want to be able to, like, be able to say that this is, like, out on the internet. And, like, I want to send shit like this to the aliens because I just feel like this is where, like, humans are at. Like, you guys might be out there traversing and walking through portals, but here we're doing discourse between Beckys and Karens. And at what point does a Becky, you know, at what point does a Becky become a Karen? And if you become a Karen, can you go back to a Becky? I feel like if I send this information to the aliens, like, they could. And also, I don't know if I call them aliens now, to the extraterrestrials, to the higher beings, or whatever. Like, you know what also, happened? Like, now that I think about, like, the alien shit happening. You remember when Trump was talking that Space Force shit? Like, it was like, we're going to go to space. We're going to dominate. We dominate here. We're going to go up there. We're going to dominate in space because America. We're going to make America great again. Then we're going to make the universe great for the first time because we're in the universe now as Americans traverse whatever the fuck, like the whole shit. I feel like one, aliens have anybody who says shit, it's always aliens have been here, they've been fucking with us, so it don't even matter. And, you know, I don't know, somebody probably fucked up at the MIB and they let some fucking shit leak. So them niggas, they dropped the coronavirus. The coronavirus is a cover up for aliens. That's my hot take. They dropped the motherfucking coronavirus so we wouldn't be able to pay attention to the fact that there's some, you know, tentacle alien sex tape, hentai is real. Like, it just, it's a whole wild fucking shit. But that's my little hot take on the coronavirus. It's not that deep. It's here because the aliens are here to take over. But anyways, what was I going with that? Oh, with the Space Force shit. Like, I really feel like Trump was up here going, like, Space Force. And we're going to go up there and take over space. And, like, an alien heard that shit. And they was just like if you, like, if you say, like, if you in your room. And you're like, I'll beat everybody ass, bro. I'll beat everybody ass in this motherfucking house. Like, I'll beat,
I beat this nigga ass. I go over there and I slap daddy at, and I like, I'll run this. I said, my shit. I ain't no bitch no more. And like a nigga next door heard you, like your big brother hear you and come inside. Who fuck you talking shit to? I ain't talking shit to nobody. I'm sorry. I mean like that. Exactly. It's what the fuck I thought. Shut your bitch ass up. Like, I really think like the aliens just like show, like just walked. I don't even think they like made a scene. I think a nigga just appeared in the fucking like White House living room and was like, my nigga, you gotta chill. Alright, you gonna stop all that fucking Space Force shit. Ain't none of that happening. Like, I feel like everybody, I feel like they knew. I feel like they just straight punk like us. Like, I just feel like aliens don't come here. Like, there's no fear. There's no even, like, all the goofy shit that we see on shit. Like, we're here to fucking take over. Them niggas don't care. Like, they just, like, it's us all, like, the memes say, like, it's just the fucking ghetto. And they look at Earth and just be like, I would never go down there. Like, look at them niggas. And them niggas down there using, what is that? Them niggas using gas? Like, that nigga put gas in a vehicle. Oh, wow. They just ride around on bombs. Have you seen how they trying to get out here? Like, them niggas just sit on explosives and hope that they get to the fucking stars. Like what? Like, we like, it's almost like we didn't come down there thousands of years ago and get them niggas the game. But you know what they was like? They was like, fuck y'all. I'm not fucking down and fucking around with y'all no more. I think that's really how aliens fucking think about us. That's how they talk about us. They don't care. They're not scared. They're not. You know what they do? Aliens probably look at us the way we look at like a dog or some shit. Like, if you were to see like the crocodile hunter, like, I think any aliens that are here, I think they broadcast that shit back to space, but it's like National Geographic, but for the universe. Like, Earth is Universal Geographic, and niggas just be up there like, it'd be aliens up there like, look at this nigga, look at this nigga down here, just look. That's how just aliens across the universe just do a look at him. This nigga's gonna, so what's that thing down there that makes the milk? So they just be pulling that shit out that nigga, at that thing, little titty milk. They killing it. What the fuck? That's how aliens look at us. I just think they look at us as like these weird, disgusting things. And that's my hot take. My hot take is aliens exist. They are sincerely fucking with us as entertainment. Like, that's how they look. They don't want to eat us. They don't want whatever. We're just like really, really primitive, goofy ass fucking beings that, you know. Aliens just want they don't want any part of like coming down here to like really deal with us. Although I wonder if like, well, not if, I guess it's technically confirmed that they exist. Like, I wonder, does that like blow up, or like would that blow up or add to I guess the way people like view, I don't know, whatever fucking my bad. Excuse me. Whatever, like, belief or fucking, whatever little shit, like, you view for yourself, like, if it's, like, aliens built this or aliens put that together, like, if they just show up tomorrow, like, how much fucking chaos and shit that would cause in the streets. Or not even in the streets, not even just, like, the idea, like, that they would just be, like, fucking mayhem and riots. But just, like, I guess, yeah, worldwide. Like, how people thought the world, like, came into existence and how that shit works would be, like, uprooted, because it'd be, like, a motherfucker can come down and be like, oh, no, like, we've been alive for, like, 10,000 years. Like, we did that, and then we just left. Like, that's how we work. Like, we just be, like, the way y'all go to the store, we go to planets, but it works in years, but we don't, I don't know, fucking perceive time the way you niggas do. Like, that would be some crazy-ass shit. I don't know if I'm here for it. I don't know if I have, like, a fucking choice either, but yeah, I feel like I have to, like, now, like, in order to be like comfortable with like aliens walking through the door and kicking it, I feel like you gotta like almost go, you know, full Joe Rogan, get you like some what's that shit, get you some like psychedelic drugs and just be ready for the fucking for the trip of the fucking year, because that, I don't know, no, I don't, like, I don't, my thing is, I don't, the only reason like I feel like people aren't talking about it
is because it is like potentially scary. Like you think about, you know, what's all the fucking scary movies, Aliens and fucking Independence Day, and they finna come down here and like blow up shit and like eat your fucking skulls and anally probe you. Who came up with that shit too? Like aliens just come down here to play in your butt. I got infinite universal wisdom, but you know what? Butt stuff. Yeah, that's the universal language, y'all. Butt stuff. Anywho. But yeah, I was having a conversation like maybe was it yesterday or a day before? Anyways, it was about like the alien shit, but it was more so like not just like the fear or, you know, craziness that, oh shit, you know, like aliens will come down here and enslave us, but just like the, like I said before, I guess the like just worldwide like identity crashes, like, because, you know, you beliefs, whether it be like religion or, you know, like just your identity, like if you're a historian, if you're a fucking atheist, you just believe like, you know, the earth came and like the Big Bang and it's like poof. But now, you know, you have these beings or whatever they may be. They are, you know, they could be niggas who are just younger, whatever alien version. Like, you just have this confirmation that there's way, 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 way more out there than you thought or than you know of. And like your just general identity, even if it's not like your identity that is just like, oh, we're it. This is it. This is how the world works. And them niggas come through and be like, nah. Even if it was like, for our benefit, like they like, no, we came to give you guys this, this, and this because this is really how the world works, and you niggas just didn't know, like, how people would react to just the idea or the notion that their worlds are just like, you know, completely. I don't know. I can't say I'm cool with it because who knows how that information, like, if I'm like, I'm saying this shit now and sounding like I'm really excited. And a motherfucker with face tentacles walk through this door, I'd probably lose my shit. Like, even if nigga was mad friendly, like, nah, bro, I didn't come here to, like, fuck with you. Like, I don't even eat people. I, like, you know, I fucking digest ambient light or whatever the fuck. I'd just be like, yo, like, but you exist. And now we have to have a actually, that made me feel better in, like, right now. It's because then if an alien comes down here, like, I could talk for, like, days about, okay, we have a lot of like religious talk on here, not to diss, but it's like, okay, if you are somebody who like say subscribes to the Bible, right? And in these pages is, you know, the beginning and end of the world. Like this is the 100% unadulterated, just unfiltered word and testament of our Lord and Savior. So if that tentacle face nigga has a Bible, does that like, does that reinforce or does that like make you disillusioned with the idea of God? Because technically, say this book is true, then who's to say you just did like that book is not the book that just was specifically for this earth? And he goes over like, what if there's like 7 billion versions of Jesus? And it's like there's tentacle face Jesus, there's fucking winged Jesus. There's robot Jesus. There's mass of energy being Jesus. This is why, I don't know, shit like this is why I really don't think, like, I'm cool with weed. Like, I don't have any issue with it, but I feel like I couldn't be somebody who continuously partakes. Because this was, like, I'm 100% sober. I'm just, like, as we're talking, we're having a deep conversation with ourselves, folks, whenever you guys listen to this. So I feel like I might have gave a few of the regular laughs. Let's think about this. So like you could just have infinite Jesuses, or if there's like a multiverse of shit, like if it's like, okay, it, you know, like if there's, cause there's like multiverse theories and there's, so if there's like a universe and this whole universe is infinite, but then there's multiple multi universes, like what? That's some crazy shit. Like, I don't like, this is, the world just became some walking DMT trip. And I think it's actually gonna take that. I might ride with, I think I might double down. I think it's cool. It's a little offset, off, yeah, offsetting, off feeling, off. It's a little scary, but it's also kind of cool. Like in a world where they're not complete, you know, take wear your fucking skin as a suit, as an Edgar suit type weirdos, it's cool. Like, I feel like alien technology. I want flying cars. Like, I just watched the fucking Sir video. Also, shout out to that guy because that shit was dope. But yeah, you know, John Redcorn, he had like a cool, like, it's, I guess, like, it's a whole bunch of cool shit in that video. But I'm like, damn, nigga, that nigga Jeep don't got no wheels. Like, he got a hover Jeep. He seems to be into hover shit too. Like, we should have a conversation about hover shit. I mean, you can come and talk about music, sir, because I'm a fan. But let's talk about hover shit and like how cool that would fucking be. And does it go fast? And like, where are the scientists that understand, like, you know, gravitational shit? Because I just feel like we should be here now. I feel like we should be, you know, at that stage in life where we're fucking, you know, I should be able to have some goddamn floaty shit. So yeah, I'm here for the aliens, man. I want some Marty McFly shit. I want us to have some trades, you know, trades of goods and services. You know, gas us up, man. You know, let us be better. I don't have no real fucking technological shit. I'm funny from time to time. I'm on the air. You guys can come talk about alien stuff. I just feel like, oh, wow, man, like, damn. It's alien pussy out there too. So now, okay. So now, with there being like alien pussy or alien dick or alien both, because nobody knows what the fuck they are, is that like a, So, okay. So I guess assuming that's a higher life, they're a higher life form. I guess that would be like, is that like a step above for sex? Because you have sex with a regular person, like you're, you know, a regular human being. That's just regular good old sex. You go below that into what we would maybe think are like lower things. Like, you start fucking animals. Now you're a weird ass nigga who delves in bestiality. But if you fucking alien, are you up fucking? Like, are you, you know, you're fucking, damn. And then does that make the alien a beat, like, if an alien fucks a human, do the other aliens look at this motherfucker like, you just fucked that dog? Because we might not be, are we just two separate entities, or are we lesser? I need the alien human discourse to kind of like step up, because I got questions and I need answers now. I just seem like I have all these questions that we're just developing. We're coming to these questions together as a unit, and I just feel like we're growing together as a family. I love you guys for it. But yeah, I'm so intrigued by this now. Like, this alien shit is just, this is lit. Like, there's just so much to do. We could be here all day just because fucking aliens, let alone, like, you know, like I said, I want my fucking floaty car. I want to be able to, I want the floaty car, and I want the goddamn, the little Rick and Morty portal gun, because that would just be like, that shit's just really efficient. I don't think I want any of the fucking like goofy shit. I just want shit that's efficient just to my life. I don't need like a gajillion dollars, just like, you know, just little regular shit that would just make my life better. That and the thing on Rick and Morty where you can watch like TV from other realities. I'm fucking with it. I could deal with this. I could do the alien thing. I don't need Starship Enterprise. I don't need all the extra shit. As much as I like Star Wars and all other shit, I don't need like all the extra wars and like a laser, you know, a lightsaber. I feel like I'd probably cut my fucking arm off with a lightsaber, because like, and then when I look at that shit, like, do lightsabers have weight to them? Because they be swinging them bitches like they heavy. But if it's light, then it's really just this fucking handle. So many things. But if and when the aliens hear this, because I believe in me and I just believe that, you know, Just a Dope Ass Podcast is alien level. Like, you could send this up in the little, you know, when they put the sound bites together, when it's like, you know, fucking Beethoven and they send up, you know, Basquiat and like Van Gogh art pieces and Beyonce tracks. Oh, Beyonce tracks. You know, you send us up there, and yeah, like, aliens will fuck with this, specifically this episode, because I'm fucking with y'all.
You know, I think we should have a conversation. Sidebar. Not even sidebar. Complete fucking detour from this alien shit. Is Beyonce the greatest rapper alive now? You know, nobody's here to talk about this, but I want to be out here and I want the question. I want the question answered. Is Beyonce the greatest rapper alive? She's out here with Meg just starting shit. And like, okay, like. And I know there's a lot of rapper people out here, people in music. What? Because then you had to ask what. Well, first of all, we're gonna play this clip. And we're gonna hope they don't fucking sue me to death because I can't pay y'all. But I just want, we got to hear this part. Just, oh, it's an ad. Good thing, because I would have fucked up the whole fucking vibe talking about. Okay. Skip it.
Baby, want no smoke with me? Okay. Then turn this motherfucker up 800 degree. My whole team eat. Chef's cause she's a treat. Ooh, she's so bougie. Won't ever teeth. I'm a savage. Had a tooth nasty. Talk big shit, but.
Okay. So, like, okay. Like, fucking, I didn't even get to the fucking demon time shit. Like,
baby,
listen
wanna
to that.
Smoke with me.
Okay.
Then turn this motherfucker up 800 degree. My whole team eat. Chef's cause she's a treat. Ooh, she's so bougie. Bon appetit. I'm a savage. Had a tooth nasty.
Okay. Sorry. I'm not sorry. Cause I'm not even like, I've said before, I'm not in the hive. Because you people don't know how to act. You really are just uncultured, just fucking crazy, spear-carrying, gun-toting, fucking just bullies. I like the thing I'm at the front door. I'm just the doorman. Like, you guys go in there and have your weird meetings or fucking sacrifices, whatever, wearing stingers. I just like to sit at the front door, sit in the parking lot. You know, I can hear you. I can hear the music. You know, I just leave the door cracked. That's where I'm at. I'm just at the front door. I'm just the doorman, you know. But, like, that was a joke statement, but also kind of true, because now with all these variations in hip-hop, you got ghostwriters, you have, you know, all these variations on what makes a good hip-hop artist, and there's clearly some of niggas' favorite artists, you know, don't write they shit, but they're, like, the best motherfuckers in hip-hop. And then you got Beyonce here, who arguably, you know, I don't give a fuck who wrote it, like, she got a better flow than, like, mad niggas. So I just want, like, does that put Beyonce in a conversation for being a top-tier hip-hop artist? Because Beyonce, like, clearly could flow better than a gajillion niggas. And then you have all these debates now between, you know, well, that nigga wrote this, but I did that, but I talked this, but I whatever that. You know, I don't know. At least I feel like Beyonce at least is in contention for, like, you know, who's that? She could definitely, like be higher on the rap list than Diddy. Like, I love, like, shit Diddy's put out. But, you know, Diddy, you know, I don't write rhymes, I write checks. So if we're in the same lane of, like, Diddy's a musical artist who raps sometimes, and then Beyonce, like, everything Beyonce touch rap-wise fucking just be completely sliding across that bitch. Like, smooth, it's fucking silky. It's just, it's fucking demon time. I don't know anything about demon time, but I know it now. And, you know, I'm concerned in the best of ways. So it's a lot of women out here talking about, you know, they finna be on demon time. And thank you. You know, like as much as Beyonce, like, shout out, you know, just, I'm gonna take a little time to just appreciate that prime, just absolute amazing Virgo energy, man. Because, you know, on one end, yes, she was mad at Hov, and it was a lot of y'all out here, you know, wanting to take bats to cars, but she also gave us, you know, surfboard, and he was grinding on that wood, and you know, bitches was out here drinking watermelon, and that was amazing. When that shit hit, that was such an amazing time. Like, just, I don't know, because I've been an upstanding, lovely human being my entire life. Glory to God. But what I heard was when that shit was going on, it was, what a time to be alive. So all I'm saying is, you know, Beyonce be doing shit for the culture. And good brother,
And okay, so you so is Beyonce now the greatest rapper alive? Is Beyonce now the greatest rapper alive?
Is she now the greatest rapper alive?
Or just, I guess, or has she been the greatest rapper alive?
That's kind of disrespectful. It's a lot of live motherfuckers that can really
rap. Yeah, I just like to start shit now. Like,
and didn't we all find out on her last solo album that she writes like 5% of her shit?
So, that's really where I'm headed.
Okay.
It's really where I'm headed. Like, okay. Oh shit, did I don't even think I hit that part. They might not have heard you well, but they heard you on there. Anyways.
Oh, okay.
Oh, fuck. The good brother DC is in the building, you know. What I was saying was, is giving credit to Beyonce and all the things she's done musically. But with all these, like, weird debates about what exactly makes a hip-hop artist, like, this one's got flow, but he didn't write it. Like, personally, if we're going like complete, just honest hip hop, you write your rhymes,
right.
You do the whole spiel.
Right.
Now, it's like 17 different variations of what niggas consider a rapper or hip hop artist. So I'm like, well, fuck, man. Whenever B get on the fucking track and says some shit, it blows. So arguably, you niggas would have to put her in the fucking argument for best rapper now.
That would depend on, well, you're saying rapper and then you asked hip hop artist. When it came to the first question, so it depends on how you differentiate between the two. Like, would you qualify her as a rapper, aka motherfuckers who don't write their shit, or would you qualify her as a hip hop artist, aka the people that are writing their stuff? So, is she a rapper 6ix9ine, or is she a hip hop artist Wale?
You know what? With that distinction, Beyonce could easily be the best rapper.
Best rapper slash performer.
Okay. Yeah, Beyonce. Sure. Beyonce is the best rapper.
in the grand scheme of trash motherfuckers that don't write their own shit, yeah, she's the pinnacle. But if we're talking about people that actually have an artistry, if you think of, say, hip-hop, in the realm of hip-hop, you have somebody like Joe Budden who got no respect during his career but is magical when it comes to writing bars, and now he's getting more love post-rap career.
And it's weird. It's mad rappers that, I don't know. Hip-hop, it seems like is like, or the music industry is just a very, like, I mean, it's not a secret. It is very, like, unforgiving.
It's fickle as shit.
Yeah, because it's like every time you watch, like, clearly you, definitely, I see it more like when people talk about the pull up.
Right.
Everybody in there might be like, I loved. And they'll be able to name, like, you know, like, oh yeah, Ordinary Love shit. Here. These songs, this bar. And I was like, how the fuck are you niggas? How are these? Like, what is the disconnect? I know it's a lot of, like, people tap into you as a person or that what they think, perceive of you as a person, as an artist.
Right.
But I'm like, fuck, man. It's these niggas on top of the world that are coming back like, no, man, this nigga got busy. Like, Joe got busy and you niggas just weren't paying attention.
I think that's part of the differentiation. Like, if you look at those that are known for having great content and ability, they may not be Beyonce level fame or say a whoever level fame in the industry, but we know that their talent is extremely high. Those are the ones that can quote this song that was made in this year. Like, they are students of the game to where they can narrow down specifically what they remember, and it's not even a popular song. The quote unquote rappers, so to speak, those that are oversaturating the market, that are here today, gone tomorrow, they're a meme hit wonder,
mm-hmm.
or a dance hit wonder, or whatever the case is, those are the people that they've probably never heard a Tupac album in its entirety.
That makes sense. Which is a trip, because, like, the arguably, you know, however you want to differentiate, but always in the conversation right now is Hov for, like, greatest rapper to ever fucking grace a mic.
Right.
Everybody talks. And even Hov, like, said it was this interview he did 2 years ago, 3 years ago. Something like that. And he talks about it like he talks about living in that white hot space is impossible to do for long term. He's like, you know, I'm always thinking about, like, you know, I don't know, like the 40-year game or longevity. And I'm just like, how do niggas be like, they like fucking with Hov, but like didn't listen to that? Because Hov really does, like, he, even when he's been able to have this longevity, but when Hov hits, it's not even like he was white hot. Like, okay, niggas love 444. But that was almost like something to be like, I'm going to you know, make a project that, you know, I'm going to drop something to keep myself not necessarily relevant.
Right.
But it's like, it's just hot enough for you to go, oh, shit, it's Hove. But he's not looking to dance in the white hot space. He's looking to be like, this stove going to just be hot. And I don't know, like, just.
I can't say specifically how he approaches it. Clearly, we're not cool enough to lace this nigga bootstraps. Like, we wouldn't even know when the brunch is going
to
be.
I'd be just trying to figure it out.
But no. I would say for him, I think dropping music every once in a while, or even dropping music as the Carters or whatever, these are business plans. Like, I'm dropping music because I know I have a certain name. So in order to keep myself relevant to make these other business ventures, and I'm known for music, I drop music just to swing dick every so often, just to make sure that people know that I'm still here and I'm still relevant. Same thing kind of like with 50. 50 will tell you, like, I don't really give a fuck about music. I know that people are checking for me music-wise, but everything that he does, everything that he touches has his music. Like, his commercials for his mm-hmm. alcohol play his music. His TV shows are new music from him. If he's helping, like, he puts his label and stamp on everything musically into his other ventures, and I think Jay-Z does similar to that.
That makes sense. I do think, too, like, you could sometimes, and not, you know, I know everybody's artistic shit is different, but you can kind of, like, I think even as, like, a business move, I guess if you can, like, mix your business with your art, is, like, if you're definitely, like, if we, okay, we say this as, like, just consumers, if I'm in-depth in the fucking music shit, I think you could definitely tell, like, even when Joe and them be talking, like, oh, this motherfucker made this hit, and they was looking for one. Sometimes I feel like Hov just might go in there and go, or a 50 or somebody who's, like, really just, I know this rap shit, I'm not necessarily looking for one. I know that there's, if it's saturated with everybody looking for that hit, if you come through and just put some shit down, holy shit, nigga, this sounds amazing, just because right. you were just trying to make music.
And I think you spent so long doing it to the point to where it's like kind of like we had our last conversation about overthinking or mm-hmm. things constantly going through your brain. When you're a creative to that magnitude, I'm sure rhymes are always popping up in your head. But because I'm retired, I'm not getting them out of my system. So I'm going to drop a track every once in a while just to kind of just let me purge, get all this shit off my mind, and then I can go sit down somewhere for a little while until it builds up again. It could be a possibility of that as well.
I believe that, since, you know, this is also like a very T-Pain friendly zone. And even him with the
most
fucking,
definitely
with the fucking
T-Pain is with the shits though, 24/7. Like,
yeah, like his shit, what's that shit, like Everything Must Go or whatever. Like he said that, and he's like, yeah, he's like, I'll just drop it. I need to get rid of it. Like, if I don't get rid of it, I'll keep fucking with it.
Right.
He's like, I just drop shit and like let it loose. I'm like, that level of
creativity is,
yeah, it's like, I'm a real artist. Like, right. I gotta do this. Like, oh, what you doing? I'm in the studio. Like, oh, y'all not just in the studio fucking. I'm like, no, I go in here and like, I'll make like 40.
Right. I'll take a break to work on my custom car and learn some other random shit, and then I'll get back to making music. But my brain is always focused on creating something.
Yeah.
Like, those are true creators, not like some random kid that's sitting at home with a Pro Tools pack.
And I mean, like,
I got to make some shit that's going to get me out of my current situation, and that's going to make me popular. Like, you're not creating for the sake of trying to create or utilizing a skill or honing in or mastering an ability. I'm doing this because I want the notoriety. It's a big difference between wanting notoriety and finding out how to be good at something and literally mastering something that you love.
Yeah, that's true, too, because, like, you even see, like, artists, like, okay, like, looking at, like, a who's the motherfucker I fuck with? Like, okay, not to say, like, Slim Thug is not any slacking of an artist, but Thug was like, yeah, you know, Thug was like, okay, you could tell, like, I'm rapping, maybe not because I love rap,
right,
but because I know rap can get me a bag, and I can use this bag right. to be a better businessman and own fucking half of Houston.
Right.
So yeah, I'm not even knocking the kids who are like, I'm doing this not because I'm a musician, I'm doing this for a bag, but to do it for notoriety, I think, is nobody should do anything for no. Even this, I like this a lot.
Right.
I want to get paid to do this shit, right. though. Like,
do I have to be super famous all across the world? No, because I still want to be able to fucking walk down the street and go into a store with some basketball shorts and a dingy T-shirt and not have to worry about my
That's
image.
That's low-key the sweet spot. Like, the I'm famous enough
to where I get,
like,
I can make some money off this shit, but still do what I want to.
Man.
Like, if I want to stand out on my balcony ass naked, somebody would just look up and be like, this fool tripping, as opposed to TMZ being outside and next thing I know, I'm a hot topic for the next couple of days.
Yeah. Like I know I give him a lot of praise for, you know, nonsense. I think the nonsense is fucking great. And I'm going to keep doing. But a nigga like Boosie, who is like, I don't like, I think Boosie's clearly more famous now because of Instagram and everything. Because
he's a caricature.
But also, if Boosie was to take a trip, take all the chains off, and you send Boosie to, like, Seattle, nobody might know him. Maybe.
Well, it depending on where you send him. Certain cities, you can send him, and he blends in with all the other dark-skinned niggas with box cuts.
But, yeah, like, I my point more so is just, like, Boosie is, like, I don't, like, niggas be, like, you know, coming out and put too much focus on maybe the hoveness or the Drakeness of being this, you know, monstrous white hot thing, which is really like Drake is a fucking anomaly.
Right.
But being a Boosie, he's like, he's because he is who he is and he's built this fan base. I was watching Vlad TV and he was talking about just the struggle with artists because it was like, well, I preface this with struggle. He was like, yeah, he's like, this coronavirus. Vlad, this coronavirus done hurt us, dog. Ain't no rapper to say can say the coronavirus ain't hit them and hurt them. And he was like, cause he's like the back end, bruh. He was like, I was bringing in 90,000 a week from doing shows, and that hurt me because I can't do that anymore. Don't know where it's at, but I can't do that anymore. And he goes, I'm making it float now because you know he'll charge a motherfucker like he said like 7,000. For those little drops he do on Instagram.
Right.
And he's like, now, you know, I'm good. He's like, I'm pulling in 60, 70,000. But, you know, it's not what it was.
Oh,
I said all that to say is that you can.
That's a legitimate problem.
Yeah. I mean, that's, you know, it's tough out here on the Boosie Estates.
Right.
But I'm mainly getting to, like, you can live fucking amazing. Like, not even good. Amazing. Like, coronavirus aside. You can be exactly who you want to be and bypass Hove or Drake level and still 90,000 a week.
I mean,
put your pussy lips on live. I will give you $1,000.
Right.
Fuck y'all.
But I think that we came up during an era where being a local was not a good thing. Whereas now,
yeah,
people don't really care about being a local. Like, I remember hearing about Boosie way back when we were younger, and I would hear stories about him being the same type of nigga he is now.
Very consistent.
Like,
extremely consistent.
Chilling out in a parking lot at a club with a chopper in his hand. Like,
yep.
just because he can, and I'm Boosie, goddammit. But other than that, he's always been known as, like, within the Negro community. he's been known with us hood types, so to speak.
With us fucking ruffians.
Right.
Hooligans.
Hooligans, hoodwinks, and all types of other forms of trickery. Like, we've known him, but he's never been a big artist, but he seemed to be doing all right to me. But I, like you said, it's, people are chasing that notoriety, especially now. People will clout chase to get some sort of 15 minutes of fame and not think of longevity. Like, you want to be like a Bootsy who can still be relevant,
mm-hmm,
10, 15 years later and still bringing in
a fucking measly 60 grand you fucking peasants.
Right.
But yeah, like I and I didn't really like even appreciate it then. Like, it just was be like, yeah, that nigga big down there. But when I was in school, like, Boosie was God. Like,
right.
I was down there, like, being an asshole. Like, he's not that great. That motherfucker owned the state of Louisiana. And I'm just,
right.
And after that, after looking at that, I'm like, I would much rather, like, if it was, like, fuck even the state. If they were like, yo, fucking Good News and Just a Dope Ass Podcast, man, they fucking run West L.A. Okay. I'm very okay with
that. I'll take that.
If I could take, I can count on just the West side.
Right.
Oh yeah, I'm perfectly fine. Yeah, like, yeah, you go to fucking Long Beach. I don't care if they don't know me in Long Beach. Don't fucking care.
It doesn't matter.
Yeah, I was over. You know, I took a trip from like I was leaving Downey. Don't care.
Right.
Yeah, I don't care that nobody knows me. If it's just this, these. If only Culver City paid for this shit, I'd be
right.
Like,
because you think about it, even for us. When you think of, say, the radio, podcast, whatever space, Big Boi is a legend here. But is he, in comparison to your Hot 95 in New York and all these other big name radio stations that are supposed to be the pinnacle of radio, he's known that way now, but he's been a legend here for 25 years mm-hmm. and living mad comfortable. Like, dude, if you could run your city, he's ran his city in the scope of radio.
Shit, I don't even think I really knew. Like, I knew, obviously, you know he's big, you might have whatever, but you really didn't know what he looked like, at least for me, until, like, movies. Like, when he was in movies, I'm like, oh, shit, that's what he looked like. Right. You might see a picture here, but it's not sticking. Right. I'm not seeing his face every day.
So, I mean, we know it more so now because of the weight loss and everything, mm-hmm. so now he's more public.
And the nigga's on billboards.
Right, you know, like. You know. When he was bigger, you may not see him as much. Just randomly, I only knew because my dad and them went to high school with him. Mm-hmm. So they'd be like, oh, Kurt's on the round. Who the fuck is Kurt? And they'd be like, oh, Big Boi. And it's not until I've been with my dad. I'm like, this nigga just be talking. I've been with my dad. He's like, what's going on, Kurt? Like, oh, what's going on too? I'm like, you really do notice?
Mm-hmm.
That's side note, my dad fucking knows everybody. I don't know how, but
no, you like damn extroverts. Like, I didn't pay attention until like maybe like high school when I'd be like, you know, I'll talk to my uncle or definitely like, but between my two uncles and like maybe like my dad here and there, I'd be like, wait a minute, you motherfuckers know motherfuckers for real, like,
right?
Wait, like y'all like really know people
because they come from an era where people had to be outside and you knew who was good at what. Like you knew people's skills. People weren't ashamed to show this. Like people knew in high school that Big Boi was good at mm-hmm. hosting and talking and being funny and joking around. Like he's been doing the same thing since he was, you know, a teenager, and he just happened to get famous for it. Like back then, people had to be outside. Right now, you can be best buddies with somebody via DM. Like you don't really have to know them for real.
Yep.
I think that's kind of the drawback to us because we also don't know who's really talented at what. Like, you say you good at this because you have an Instagram page for it, but we don't really know your skill or really know you because we ain't got to be outside like that. Like, we were the last generation of kids that had to for real be outside.
That is true.
And we couldn't be outside because niggas was shooting.
That's also true. Like, I can speak to that because I definitely remember being like, and I don't know, you know, I'm sure there has to be, like, kids in high school and it's like, oh, hey, you're funny. Like, but I remember, like, okay, like, oh, yeah, I made a couple niggas chuckle in high school. Like, I could, when I was in a mood, like, I could talk and, like, maybe get some shit entertaining. I was like, so this makes sense. But, like, yeah, if I'm in high school now, I'm like, shit, that motherfucker's funny online. But I don't know, is that nigga funny, like, and how that transfers or, like, correlates over. Like, oh, you're funny on the internet. Can you be funny in this room of people or vice versa? Because, shit, even, because you see, like, what's that? You'll see, like, comedians try to do the, like you see, like, I don't know, insert whoever like was a really big maybe Comic View comic and them trying to do the shit online. It's like, I don't get this shit, bro. I don't get memes. My memes, this might be funny, but I didn't put the right, you could be like, I didn't put the right font, like, so now it's not fucking funny.
Unless you're Duval or Tony Baker.
Yeah, Duval's just, yeah, Duval, like
these
just,
those, there's very few of them, and DL. Like, there's very few of them that come from the Comic View era that have surpassed their fame.
Is that just a them thing? Because Duval seems like somebody who's done almost, I would put him in, like, Drake in the same thing as far as they keep themselves immersed in the culture in some way. Even if, like, this is not my shit, I'm going to keep myself around it so I know at least how to whatever. It seems like some comics kind of go, I'm a stand-up. I'm the shit in stand-up land, but I don't give myself an avenue back to this. I just try to jump back and forth, but you need, like, a bit of, like, a, I don't know, you need, like, a bridge.
Right. I don't know. Because I think for Duval, like, Duval was singing and making songs out of comedy back when he was doing mm-hmm. stand-up a long time ago. I'm watching, you know, his stand-up.
You think you fucking wit. You gonna get your shit split.
Yeah. That was my shit in high school.
That was funny as fuck.
And that was Duval, Roland Powell, before he started going by Duval. So, yep. I mean, I think for him, it's just a matter of he stayed himself until it popped.
Mm-hmm.
And now we're in an age where traveling is important. He's been traveling.
My life is great.
Funny-ass songs. Been this way. Right. Funny-ass songs and stuff can get you famous, because that's what people can turn into, trying to be an artist because I made a funny ass song or something along those lines. That's like, true. I was doing this just for shits and giggles. Like, yeah, I think it's just perfect timing for him. Somebody like DL, he transitioned. He went from stand up to being on a radio, from putting a little bit of politically inclined things in his stand up to where now I'm talking about it on the radio. Like, people just ended up maneuvering into the right space. Ricky Smiley, you know, stand up doing that. Now he's on the radio. Mm-hmm. But I think Duval is the only one that's been the same exact way the entire time. And it just ended up fitting for right now.
That makes sense.
Like, now I get to show y'all the dumb, silly shit that I do or be around. Or I get to show you my perspective. I say something that may be quote unquote triggering or off the wall or whatever the case is, but it's some real shit to it. And now I get to show you a picture or a meme that, like, everything I said, y'all thought I was lying. Now here's proof.
I think that shit is, I think that actually might be like, because I was having a conversation, I had like discussed, oh, you really like Duval? I'm like, well, yeah. But I'm like, also, I'm like, it's not even that I 100% always agree with what he says. I agree a lot, though.
Yeah.
But I'm like, I agree with, I like the idea of what I think Duval represents. Like, right. You can, everything, because I'll get that. Like, oh, you say, like, I do say a lot of wild shit. But I was like, honestly, if you wanted to sit down and talk about it, or if you just spent 5 seconds to, like, take what the wild shit I said was, understand that, yes, it was wild, it was crude. But then, like, if you just, like, just scrape off that little bit, did it make sense?
Right.
You, did it make sense? Did it make sense?
Scrape the brown off the toast. It's still toast, ain't it?
You know what? Scrape. That's, God damn it. What was it? Where the fuck is,
go ahead.
Scrape the fucking brown off the toast.
No, it's still toast. It's still nice and toasty. Put some butter and some jelly on that bitch and eat it. It's still what it is. It doesn't change just because it doesn't look, or it's not presented the way that you would prefer it to be. It's still exactly what it is. And I also, because I get that too. Is it really me being crude or snarky or whatever the case is? Or are you just overly sensitive and you expect me to conform to your comfort level?
A bar.
There's a difference. We have two different ways of communicating. Clearly, I'm a little bit more open in my communication style. And clearly, you may be a little bit more reserved or traditional or whatever word you want to throw on it. I don't identify that way. So am I really being mean or rude or wild or whatever the case is? Or are you really just like one extreme and I'm a different extreme, so to speak? They're not going to match up. I can, like you said, put your pussy lips on live. Some, oh my God, pussy is such a nasty word. Like, you have one, though. Would you rather I say labia? No, labia is just, that sounds weird. Well, that's the actual term for it. Either way, I'm describing some genitals.
Yeah.
It's just whatever context of word that you're using, it's still the same thing.
That could be, like, I guess, my favorite joke, or like bullshit the fuck people was like saying, like social construct, but kind of like how you're perceiving things or your language, like it's all conditioning and social construct. And maybe,
right,
you know, maybe you could be like, maybe you needed me to be crude. Not to say you got to rock with what I said, but just, right, for you to just look a little bit and reevaluate why the fuck you even think that shit I said was really that bad.
Right.
Like, that's it. That's all.
And especially if it's just us. If I wasn't saying it to offend you personally, I can understand if you, like, that made me feel a certain kind of way because I'm used to this and I'm not used to that, but I understand that's my personal discomfort, as opposed to you're being very disrespectful or you're being this or you're being that. Like, no, I'm not being that if you look at it, because you can tell I'm not trying to be this way on purpose. Or you could just ask. It helps to ask what my intent is with what I'm saying. We can have a conversation about it.
Well, you're asking for, you know.
Yeah, I know.
Communication. Which is, I don't know. Like, it's just, it's not the best. And I'm not saying this is like, I'm a grand communicator all the time.
Not at all.
But yeah, I don't know. Like, people just evaluating, like, and continuously, like, I feel like I think people look at it like work. Like, what's, like, you just have to continuously reevaluate and, you know, recontextualize how you fucking,
but that's
how you deal with shit. Like, everything,
anything in life, like in the grand scheme of life, let's just be honest. We as human beings, we suck at communicating
terribly
because there's so many different ways to communicate. We got 50,000 fucking languages. And even within those languages, there's different dialects and different ways to communicate that same one language. And we fuck that up, mm-hmm, all the time. like this whole country speaks a version of English that is not the original correct way of speaking it, but yet we'll talk shit about somebody else. Like, we can go to England and talk shit about how they speak English. Like, you do realize y'all stole it from them, right? Like, let's, how you gonna talk shit about somebody that originated some
That's
shit?
That's where I was headed, because it's like, it was, what's that fucking show on, it's like the little internet show where, like, they have the rappers come talk to the kids and the kids always say shit or whatever.
And I have no idea.
It's a fucking, it's on, whatever, but it's these two kids and they'll, like, have rappers come on and they'll talk to them and have, like, awkward conversation where the kids will ask them awkward shit. So you, when you're in your lyrics where you said this isn't this, what's that mean? So I think it was a nigga, the British nigga, that was like, boom, 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 bat. Like, he was up there and the kid was like really fucking with him, but he was just like, he's like, well, when you learn how to speak English, and he was like, English, you will talk to me about English. And I was just like, well,
and there you have it, folks.
He got a point though, like, because that nigga speaks it like the original it with all the, you know, about it, all that, that fucking whatever,
it's fucking blokes,
that shit,
all that.
So yeah, people, I don't know, yeah, people communicating or not.
I just want to go live there for like 2 years just to get the twang down. If I could mix the country twang with a London twang and come back and just fuck people's brains.
Here's where
up.
I think I have to go there, because I think if I'm having like a good, if I'm having one of those good like stints of watching, you know, enough of the telly, I can like, you know, you can mimic it pretty well. Where I know I would fuck up is when I would fuck up on, like, you know, I'd be like, you know, I like throw it in the trunk. And they'd be like, you mean the boot? And I'd be like, oh, fuck, damn, I didn't say the fucking, like, I would be terrible with, like, the fucking, the slang and shit. Like, that's where I know, like, a real British person would be like, no.
Jose said that you're dumb as shit and your memory's terrible and the show is called Arts and Raps.
I'm all of that.
I'm exaggerating. He would have just said it's called Arts and Raps. I just wanted to throw that in there. Shout it's out to fine. Jose.
Oh, yeah, Jose's a fucking, like, Jose's like in the WWE and shit now. Like, fucking like a whole, you know, suplexing niggas and shit. And hit motherfuckers with chairs. Like,
Jose's, I mean, I feel like hitting somebody with a chair every day.
And Jose gets to do it.
It would really be nice. It would really be nice. If you could take, random tangent, if you can take one person to hit with a chair right now, not one of them crash dummy ones that kind of fold up when you hit people in the W, like a legitimate, like, I'm mad type chair, like break it Jeff Jarrett style over their head, like, which, who would it be and why?
This is sounds like fanfare. I was talking about him earlier, but I would say Trump, but not for anything like political. He's the terrible person. I just feel like his body built weird, and I know like he would fall, and like it would just be this whole spectacle. Like he would, because I would hit the nigga hard, and I feel like he would like curl up, and his fucking, his like shirt would come out, because I feel like it's barely tucked in there holding on for dear life, and I feel like it would just fall out, and it would be this fat, just
saying
pale,
fall like Bobby Hill.
Yeah, it would just, yeah, it would be this pale, nothing under, it'd be this orange face, but this pale stomach, and he would just have like, and I feel like him going like just, like his scream, it would be amazing. It would be the funniest shit ever.
This is the worst thing. It's the worst thing that's ever happened in my life.
Mm-hmm.
He just hit me with a chair. What are you guys gonna do about it?
Yeah, that shit. Wow.
Toupee come off. And
nobody
everything.
Ever talks about like how bad it must be that you have to be like a Secret Service and you're stuck with this nigga for life.
Reassign me.
Fucking, I quit.
Like,
bro.
It depends, because I feel like some of them may be Secret Service agents that we only work with somebody while they're in the White House, and then we're assigned to work with people after.
Your face is your money maker.
It is my money maker. That was YouTube, you guys.
I thought he was going to say, is it my face or your face? Who is he talking to?
I think he'd just be talking to, like, customers, but.
Because my face don't make me no money. If I could use my face to make me some money, that might be how I start my OnlyFans. But that's not. We're not going to talk about that right now. Anyway.
Right, because not only motherfuckers like, oh my God, you're so handsome. Just pay for it. Pay for it. I'm finna walk around.
You think I grow this beard for me?
I'm telling you, like, if I could just, I might walk around with a mask. Oh, we got masks now. I might actually like just instill like the black mask shit from Batman. Like, I'm covering all this shit. You get nothing. You don't get the bald. You don't get nothing.
Right.
Nothing.
We should do that. Marshmallow makes a pretty good career out of it. And I'm, dead mouths and all of those.
I'm not opposed to
DJ
it. And let me fuck around and learn how to. Like, fuck all this shit.
All you see is an outfit, man, and a big ass head with some flashing eyeballs bopping.
Oh, it's five. My bad. All right, people. That's it.
Oh shit.
Oops.
Timed. Whoops.
Yeah. Just a Dope Ass Podcast. Follow us on every fucking thing you can follow us on. I'm Chad Awesome on fucking social media, King Carter. Feel free to follow and enjoy. And because this is the best shit ever, put your pussy lips on live. We'll give you. I'm not gonna give you anything, but. Shit.
Put your pussy lips on live. I give you a thousand.
I love this nigga, man. This is just.
Put your pussy lips on live.
I give you $1,000.
Pussy hustling ass nigga.
Put your pussy lips on live. I give you $1,000. Put your pussy lips on live. I give you $1,000. Put your pussy lips on live. I